reaching more and more screens around the world every week. On Stage, so much more than entertainment.
This 90s dancehall arose to prominence as
have a new style, what them call it.
The girl them DJ.
Swag, swag,
dang it.
The girls them.
And is now struck by love, believe it or not. So much so that he is singing about it, literally. Mr. Lexx is who we're talking about.
I'm Mr. Lexx.
Spammer!
Who's our guest in this segment right now on stage. Sir Lexx.
What about, man?
Blessed love, sir.
Thanks for having me, man.
Good to have you.
It's good to be here. All right, sir, explain
this love struck for me, or this struck by love. What is that exactly? You fall for some girl or something?
No, not really. Well, for explain, for you really understand it still, it's been a while since I've been out. So, yes, you know, everybody see me and be like, yo, Lexx, where you do? Like, where you do? And, you know, I'm like a young artist and I'm going, you know, where you do? We want back some real 90s artists and I was like, yo, you know what? I have to wait for, you know, the right timing to come out. So this year has been a good year for me.
Yeah, is it?
The first good thing was Fiat, the car company. Mm-hmm. They chose my song for their main campaign this year. And that was a good look for the worldwide main campaign. So, you know, worldwide. Yeah, that's a good look.
So from Lexus to Fiat.
Yeah, so and that same song, which is Bad Boys, produced by my friends from Colombia, named El Freaky.
Okay.
It went to number one a couple of weeks ago in the summer in Colombia. So okay. I had the number one song for like 2 weeks in Colombia a couple of weeks ago. So that was major. So with that said, I was like, yo, if I come back out on the scene, I can't come back out. The same jump up thing. I'm just try to do different. So, you know, me and Fui Music Group and Lock City Records and CD Bang, and, you know, we link up and say, all right, let's do something. And, you know, them drop a one drop rhythm. And I was like, you know what? A whole heap of artists in the industry have to tell me, say, I can't sing. And the one thing you do not do is tell me that I can't do something. Is what I say. So,
all right, let's go to the song.
Because I've seen lovers parading in the park, and I've seen heartbreaks. I know how it feels to be left in the dark. And then you're struck by love. What do you do when the fear of love is chasing you all my life? I have never tried.
Well, now. Struck by love, Mr. Lexx. You know something about Fui Music?
Fui Music Group and Lexx City Records.
Gentlemen, I'm coming to get my
yeah,
singing.
Impressed, right?
Yeah, I'm singing true now.
I was amazed when we turned on
Lexx. Lexx can sing, so.
Everybody said the same thing.
That sounds good.
Thanks, man. I appreciate it.
I don't know. I'm no big judge of talent.
I appreciate it.
But man, I believe you're singing, Redrick.
I appreciate it, man. Well, you know, like,
how tough was this to do? I mean, how did you get it there?
It wasn't
like 50,000 times?
Well, not really. You see, I was taught by the best, Steely and Cleavy.
Yes.
I was taught by the best, yo. So keys and bars and all of that, I know. So I know that, like, the back of my hands, is what I say.
Okay.
So I know when to go high, I know when to go low, I know, you know, where to inhale, where to exhale, and all of that.
So you had been sitting on this all this time?
That's what everybody's saying. Yeah, but the thing is, like I said, every time, like, we try it, because my vibe is more time, when I hear a song, I'm like it, man, I pull up at the studio and I sing it and thing. But every time, like, I try to, you know, put out that something there, there's always an artist that say, yo, load that singing thing there. You know, you can't sing, you're a DJ. And I always be like, really? And especially Mr. Vegas, he might always shut me down. You know, he always shut me down. He said, damn, really? Some artists think this are like, damn, dude not even know how creative me is with keys and bars and chords and all of that, so never bother paying the mind. But I guess everything happened at the right time. This was the time now, and you know, I want to make an impact in coming back into the business. So, you know, I'm glad everybody like it, and I'm, you know, I appreciate the love and everything. So
you're getting that kind of response?
Yeah, the response is amazing, man.
It's positive everywhere.
Yeah, the response is amazing, man. Because every time somebody hear it, it's the same thing. Like, either old lamp on his all along, dog. You should follow my Instagram page, man. One Mr. Lexx.
On Mr. Lexx.
Yeah.
Because you were saying come back. But it's coming home to us, all of us, Jamaicans, and all of us, even us in the media, that we are not really on top of what's going on in
for
the
real
world of music and what's happening to artists, some of you who we're not hearing from.
For real.
Because so many of you we're hearing doing great things. General Degree is another one from the 90s who was doing great things out there that nobody knows
about. We were in We Belgium the other day, general degree. Really. I had my book up enough for the artists. Not for the artists, then where it's not really here on the main running. But even now, like with me, I'm not gonna be one of the elder artists them where bash the young artists them. You see, I'm not gonna be one of, like, cause the young artists them don't do them thing and they're getting popular and they're getting rich on it. So clearly somebody like it and love it. So I am not gonna sit here and say, well, for the music is trash or what am I doing is not good. They're doing their thing. I had my fair amount of that when time we just coming out of the business from the artist them before me too. You know what I'm saying? So what I think though is with our music, I think the people who we put at the forefront of a dancehall to be the face of a dancehall is not academically good or creative enough or have the visions to bring our music further than where it is. Their vision is to be in the party with NSC and 100 man behind them.
We want to congratulate you, Reggie. And we love it when man can make progress and
make moves. Is amazing.
And when them surprise us like you did with that.
Yeah.
With that song. That we love that.
Everybody go get it on iTunes. Struck by Love, and you know, follow me on Instagram, one Mr. Lexx, O-N-E-M-R-L-E-X-X.
All right.
Oh, by the way, quick plug. Maguire 50 grand, because I'm doing a Struck by Love challenge right now, and like mad people is doing it. If you check out my page, it's crazy. So on November 5th, the person with the most views, I get 50,000 Jamaican. So that's the one on now. So on October 18th is the last video I post, so y'all get your videos in right now. And then, you know, November the 5th, 50 grand.
All right, sir. Lexx, thank you, sir, for being here.
Thanks for having me.
And there you have it. Mr. Lexx.
Struck by love.
Struck by love. Right here on stage. Stay with us. Still to come, Ricky Chupa, Spearhead's effort to raise funds for Ishawna. And later, Ishawna. Where is she since the breakup with Joe? Wow, she will answer. Coming up right here on stage.
We can't catch a breath, we are embracing so passionate. That love you're exciting like a school set.
Reaching more and more screens around the world every week. On stage, so much more than entertainment.
Welcome back as nations of the world rally to aid hurricane-ravaged Haiti.
More than 1 million people have been affected by the disaster.
The Jamaican Dancehall Fraternity seeks to make its contribution through a benefit, a special benefit. This event takes the form of a massive dance, spearheaded by selector Ricky Chupa, who is our very special guest right now, right here on stage. Mr. Chupa, sir.
Yeah, man, respect.
I'm going to congratulate you right away for putting this together. I think it's a very, very good move, and I feel proud that dancehall is doing this.
I always do humanitarian work, so it has come like a second nature, you know.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
It's your idea?
Well, it's a brainchild of three persons, you know. Mm-hmm. Michael Dawson, Gary Exodus, and Rick Chupa, because, like, we started this new company. Yes. I opened a new place at 6 Cargill Avenue. We call it House of Dancehall. One day we did it, and after the hurricane, we were saying, all the wild people always collect money, and they must say this, they must say that. Money always get rubbed up. When it comes to artists and people in the entertainment fraternity, who have clothes like we, you know? What about shoes we do? Certain clothes, we wear them, and we wear them again, because we are star. So I said, we can start, and you know, we can get all the artists them for rally and give them support. So Gary starts to me say, yo, can we just put on an event and just bring it to the public? We don't want no monetary donation from them.
You don't want money?
No, we don't want no money. We don't want no money from nobody.
You want things?
We want, yeah. Like, you know, hurricane match if you come to Jamaica and you know, blow. So all the people have all the canned food in their house. Excess stuff.
So it's anything?
Anything, yeah. Canned food and clothes.
So if someone has money, what they do?
We don't want buy money. Stuff with it, buy stuff and care can give us.
Okay.
And even when we do this benefit dance Sunday, we're not gonna stop there. You can come drop off things anytime after. We're gonna tell you when we're gonna have the cutoff. Mm-hmm. You know? We're gonna make it go on for a few weeks
at the same venue.
Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Good. Wonderful. So what support are you getting?
The whole artist industry. We get support from all of the artists, them, Tanya Stevens, them, Bunty Killer, them, everybody, you know, mm-hmm. Farley,
nice.
With the thing, you know, Peter Metro, all of the youth, them, all the youth, them, Exodus Studio, and the feedback is good, and aim like overseas. Mm-hmm. My whole heap of fans, everybody just start retweet it, and I say, okay, them have always said, I'm telling people to carry this, come give me that, come give me, come drop it off. So the feedback is very good.
And some of the sounds?
Some of the sounds, like most of the top players, them, you know, Ricky Chupa, Ema, Exodus, we have Freddie from Jaro, you know, Pink Panther, everybody just fall in and just, oh. You know, give us strength. It not gonna be none of this, this jiggy something and the. No gun song or them sort of thing. They want the music to clean and nice and, you know, because we expect certain people to come here, to come drop off, you know, give donations, and
okay.
We want them to come see
so
the next side
time?
Of dance hall.
What time them can start drop off?
Them can start drop off from around, say, 3 o'clock in the evening, you know, because we're going to set up from 3 o'clock in the evening.
A music player?
Yeah, music player from early, yeah. Oh. And we're going to be there.
Okay, and you're going all night?
That place, it have a license to go until 4 o'clock, you know.
The venue is approved.
Till 4 o'clock. Yeah, it's approved.
To go to 4?
Yeah. But about the right of Cargill Avenue, you know, say, nobody don't live right of Cargill Avenue is a place where are just mostly business places. Business. So now nah, disturb nobody.
Cool. Nice. All right, Trooper, you know, you can't come here and not talk about a few issues. So we must have asked you about some current affairs. First of all, who's running the selector business, right?
Well, when I say run the selector thing right now, everybody do them thing, you know. Everybody had them thing. You understand?
The top man there, right?
Wah, wah, with the thing now. Everybody's turned selector. Everybody okay. Just, anybody can buy a laptop now and just download some songs off of the internet and same as a selector. So, financial wise, if you don't really have a name in the thing, and you know, really respected, it come like say, if I have the choice now for go in the sound system thing, I wouldn't do it.
Oh, wow.
Because when it comes to Jamaica, you know, really, I make the money at Jamaica.
What do you make of? Culture clash, the big culture clash event in
England?
In London. Shouldn't that be where we are now?
Well, we should, you know, but the thing is, it's true the stigma we come with dancehall music. Mm-hmm. We remember say, we have some whole heap of sore issues, you know, when it comes to dancehall music, like, you know, the man who said we have burned certain people and the stigma and the violence and all of them things there. So if I say corporate Jamaica, really, you know, Carly said I'm never really interested to get involved in another thing. You understand? So after a while now, you know, the role has changed. The role has changed. So, mm-hmm. You know, it's just like a more level playing field. So corporate Jamaica kind of endorse it. But right now, we have this Guinness clash going
right.
On again.
Guinness Sounds of Greatness.
Yeah, Guinness Sounds of Greatness. And yes. I'm one of the judges in that. One of the resident judges, mm-hmm. Me Richie Feelings. And last week, Friday, we had the first stage in. And it was very, very
the launch,
good.
Yes.
Yeah, we had the launch last week, Friday.
So that's a little light at the end of the tunnel there?
Yeah, it's a light at the end of the tunnel. But the thing is, the sound system culture is not really respected in Jamaica, you know. Mm-hmm. It's not really respected in Jamaica because, put it this way, I go to a Rotterdam festival, I play most of the big festival them in Europe, you know. I clash, me and Tony Mataran clash at Rotterdam festival. And it was clean. No disrespect, none of them sort of a foolishness, certain songs, okay, this song cannot be played, that can't happen, and it was good. And in front of you have around 30,000 people.
The Mavado, Papi, Popcorn Clash. What's your take on it?
Well, you want to go on. I mean, I enjoy it still, you know. I mean, I enjoy it still, but, you know, Papi threw in the towel and I said, boy, you know, corporate thing and this and that still. To me, I wouldn't throw in my towel still. Mm-hmm. I wouldn't throw in the towel. I don't want to ride with it still. But, you know, I'm having management, management team. And the thing is, and like one time when certain thing would have gone and it just stay at Jamaica. You have social media now, so you have to know where you do. And then the embassies all over the world. Mm-hmm. They watch the music like arc.
Okay.
So certain time, certain song we would do on them thing there. And through them, I watch them thing there. And every publicity, a good publicity, so.
So you can understand and appreciate why
he's... Yeah, why I'm stopped.
Why I'm stopped.
Yeah, because remember say, he have a U.S. visa, you know. Mm-hmm. And the way his career move, to me, he need a U.S. visa for really go there and make that money, so. It's a wise move to me still. And then, he never have nothing to lose still, you know. Because I'm over still, you know. So if you say, I'm over, you can say, okay, yeah, yeah, me enjoy it still. Because to me, in a sense, it helped revive back Movado career in Jamaica. So him do more good for Movado than more Movado do for him.
What should Sting do this year?
They ain't gonna have no Sting this year.
They won't be a Sting?
No, they ain't gonna be a Sting this year.
You don't want a Sting?
Are you
confirming that there'll be no Sting?
You are going. As far as what me hear and say I go on, Sting now happen. Because the little firewood for Burn, Sting is a clash show, you know. And the fire for Bone, a puppy and a Movado and the war fizzle out. So who have a clash?
Oh,
I look for Massacre and I look for Kaliado and say, all right, I'll catch back for fire and or something. But nothing a go on right now.
Mm.
Nothing really a go on. Everything just calm.
Wow. Well, you know, so where are you with your visa though? Any change in that?
Well, the visa thing is a very sad issue because it's like I had this lawyer from Miami who was dealing with this visa issue. More than 4 or 5 years from my last my visa. And him charge an X amount of money and give him, and him not do nothing. See? File a work permit, went to the embassy, and there was no representation there. So we have to know, we have to go to Obama and find the next lawyer and start the process all over again. But this new lawyer that I got now, What this man had done in the like 4 years, this man that in a space a 1 month.
Okay, so you're still, it's still possible you may get it back.
Yeah, that is up to the United States.
Of course, the government of the U.S.
Yeah,
yes.
But you know,
you're playing for gay issue. How did that impact your career?
You not do my career nothing. Cause see me and same way Winfred, saying if something did happen with that, you not hear say okay, trooper go certain places, and maybe the people don't get violent and run him down or something and he have to take care of himself. My dad Jamaica same way. Me I travel same way. Me I do my things same way. And the thing is, it get more fans. And then I say, me the most notorious selector you have in our business, you know.
Yes.
No selector no notorious like me, you know. And if me can stand up on my foot, you know, and defend the reggae music that we may play all over the world. Saying, if you carry that craft all over the world and a business about race, creed, our people lifestyle. You understand? Me, I help the dunce one them. Because Mr. Lexx earlier, have a lot of dunce people in the reggae music. They are very dunce because life changed, the thing changed. The whole world changed. It has changed. It really changed. So to me, it was a win issue also. Because remember I said this notorious YouTube video that I did when I was drunk? Some things were said on that video, you understand? We don't really come from the art. But you're drunk and you go through a certain situation and you make certain speech. But the thing is, for you can stand up on your foot and say, yeah, yeah, me, right now, this is who I am and this is my lifestyle when I live. I play music to people. Me not care them race or them sexual lifestyle or thing like that. You understand? So I'm not busy with people want to say no. Like Usain Bolt. He means an ambassador for Jamaica. Mm. I'm an ambassador also. Me am one of the biggest selectors from Jamaica worldwide. When it comes to even David Radigan, me the only person who me and him clash all over the world. Me the only person who defeat him all of Europe and them place there. So I'm an ambassador. So I'm not a kid no more. So I'm going to stand up on my foot and know and say, this is the music we may try to preserve and try help. It's a dancehall culture. So I'm going to sure him, the authorities and people who are out there will look down upon this thing and say, okay, they are like that and them always bash them set of people. So no, we are not like that.
So you're offering leadership here?
Yeah, I have to do that.
Super.
Them youth are coming out, them new youth, yeah? Them have certain ideology, you understand? And then them are live for please certain people. Because if them do certain things, they must say, okay, you do this and you go on that way there and so forth.
Lexx has played a song for us, did a song. You're singing. What you thought of it? You heard it?
Well, I'm going to tell you something now, Winfred. Me as a youth, when it comes to music, I feel music, you know. Mm. You know, when I have a bad song, I just full of cold bump. That's my gift. That I can't hear an artist and I just know that the artist is going to bust. And I can't hear a song for you first. And I know say that's it. And I see an artist and I just hear something for him. I know say, am I the next big thing? And Lexx sang a play and some little goose pimple touch me. Because me, I say, it surprised me.
Lexx give you goosebumps?
No, Lexx give me the song. The song. Yes.
Oh my God.
It's with a vibe, with a vibe. I still don't care the thing while I go there with Fred. See, it's a need clash of
one. It's a big clash.
Yeah, need clash of one with a while ago, man.
Oh boy, it's true, man. Well, it's always good to have you, man.
Yeah, man. It's
always
pleasure,
good
man.
To make. Shout out then. Give the people a last talk about the
event.
Well,
we just want the people know, say, yeah, we need the support. We really need the support because it could have been us, Jamaica, in other plight, yeah?
Yes,
and
as
we
course,
say, a little
yes.
bit of rain just fall today, and we see a lot of suffering going to Jamaica also. So, you know, we have to help. We'll get by the blessing. And see, John never sent it come here. Come again. And John, we got some woman just know, say, yo, them are help, so go and protect them from a disaster.
Tupa again. Commendation, yeah, sir. Good effort. Good
praise
work. Keep it up, brethren. Keep
and,
up the good work.
The address of the thing, 6 Cargill Avenue again, House of Dancehall.
House of Dancehall.
Yeah. New okay. home of Dancehall.
The new home of Dancehall for yeah. Kingston. For Capital Kingston. Ricky Chupa. All right, stay with us right here on stage, still to come. Glamour Queen, Ishawna. Where has she been since the breakup with Joe Bogdanovich? She'll be here to answer.
Someone said, come now, come try, come on to lick a little niceness.
I'm gonna need all of this.
And where you come now, tell me if you like it.
Reaching more and more screens around the world every week. On stage, so much more than entertainment.
Welcome back. In July of this past summer, Ishawna announced her departure from Joe Bogdanovich's Down Sound Records, an announcement that sent shockwaves throughout the dancehall space, as this was the label that broke and nurtured the restraining order singer into a credible dancehall star.
So stop, watch out, my good.
Even more shocking was that the breakup came just days before Joe's latest business acquisition in entertainment. The greatest reggae show on earth, Reggae Sunfest, on which Ishawna had a headline billing.
There's something going on that I really can't talk about, or do I really know about.
Mm-hmm.
I've never experienced anything like this in my life.
Needless to say, she was a no-show at Sunfest. And today, 3 months later, it remains unclear what caused Ishawna's sudden departure from Down Sound Record. How it impacted her career and where she is now are some of the questions she's here right now on our stage to answer. Ishawna.
Hi, Winfred.
Welcome. Well, you know, you've been evading, I think.
No, I wasn't. But, you know, I was all over the place working as usual, very busy, so that's
what
it was.
Oh, so you've been busy even in all the...
Yes, I have.
The breakup and mm-hmm. the... Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
So your summer was a big one?
Yes, it was very, very... You know, it was a great summer. Can't complain.
Oh. So. What I'd like to know is whether the breakup
mm-hmm.
is finalized.
Yes, it's finalized.
So you are satisfied with how you came out of it, with where you are now, with what
yes.
you got out of it?
Yes, of course. I'm satisfied because at the end of the day, I had to do what I had to do. You know, it's not really an emotional decision or, you know, a personal decision. It was just a business decision. You understand? And business-wise, I felt like that's what I needed to do at that time for my career. So I had to just step out and just do what I had to do.
Mercedes-Benz was at the center of it. Where's the Lexx now?
It's still there. Why is that at the center of it?
It was featured heavily in the whole thing.
Yes, but it wasn't featured in the breakup of me leaving.
Who has the car now?
I have my car.
Oh, so it's in your name and all?
Yes.
Is there a new team, new company? What?
Well, right now, you know, I've been getting a lot of offers and stuff like that, but of course, I'm not jumping into anything. Right now, I'm just doing my thing independently at the moment until I am sure. When the right offer is there, then I will make a move. But right now, no.
Are people seeking you out?
Of course.
Offers are there?
Yes, a lot of offers are there, actually. Mm-hmm. Ever since the news broke, a lot of offers has been coming in, as I said. But, you know, I'm not really trying to jump into anything, you know, so we'll see.
How different are you now from 2 years ago when you got the break? What do you know about the business and so on? That is more than what you knew then.
I know a lot more about the business. a lot more about the business. I know a lot more of what I need to do. I know a lot more of what needs to be done to attain what I want to attain out of the industry. So it's just a learning experience at the same time, you know? And to me, life is about change. Evolving is about change. You can't stay one place forever. You understand what I mean? I say it's all about growing and changing. And sometimes you have to just make certain decisions for your future, your well-being. And you can't really think 2, 3, 4 times about it. You just have to go with your gut instinct and make sure you know, say, all right, it's a calculated decision. You just make the right move. Everybody in the need to understand why you make the decision and why you make. You just have to just do what you have to do. You understand?
Do you have a relationship with Joe still?
No, I don't have a relationship with Joe or anything or Donson, but I would say it's not an enemy thing. I don't have a problem with Joe. I don't have a problem with Donson, but it's like it was really a business relationship, so now we don't really discuss business anymore. So it's like...
Yeah, but what if you're called for something? Will you take the
job? Of course. Of course I would take the job, because at the end of the day, it's business, you know, and... If I'm available and if the price is right, I would of course do it.
But why didn't you do the last one?
Of course, everybody know that my management was keeping some face, and I felt like certain things weren't put in place for me to give more than 100% to my fans.
Okay.
Rehearsals, everything had to be put in place, and I'm not talking about rehearsals two days or a day before the event, no. I'm talking I needed rehearsals weeks before the event, because at the end of the day, everybody knows that Donson is a part of some fest. People have come out to say Ishawna. Some people have got off them ideas that Ishawna is on it because of Joe. You understand? So it's a lot of pressure on me as an artist, and I had to give my best, more than my best, to my fans. You understand? And I felt like a lot of things weren't really put in place,
okay,
you know, for me, so I had to make the right decision at that time.
And that's understandable. Yeah. But then we still don't know why it was so sudden.
I just
the breakup was sudden.
It wasn't. Really sudden. Still,
it was. It was in the works.
I mean,
it was in the works quietly, coming, leading up.
Really and truly, it's gonna be sudden. Yes, as what's gonna look that way, of course, because you know, to everybody else, it's sudden. But what I am saying is, I had to do what I had to do.
You were definitely missed at some fest.
Oh, I was?
Yes, you were. And in fact, there weren't enough ladies on it.
Yes.
Last year, all of 7 on the show. And in fact, Dance All Night was like 5.
Okay.
And that was the biggest number ever in the history of the festival. And we thought it was a good thing for women in music. And then down to just Spice.
Yeah.
This year, you know, and everybody and looking out for it.
Yeah, that's why girl did that for make sure she prepared.
Hoping that you would return, and even Joe wanted you to come.
Yeah, I mean.
He told me that.
Well, if you wanted me to be there, certain things would have been in place, and it wasn't. I have to go out there as an artist.
Okay. All right, so talk about now your big video. I'm sure you can't wait to drop your video.
Yes, of course. My new song, Private My Page. It's a counteraction to Black and Elite and the girl in my rear feet. And then I go on and I'm like a bag
of time.
It's a bad. So girl, they just have to do the video feet. So right now, I'm not going to see the video.
You keep calling yourself girl. Explain that girl thing.
I don't know. It's just my little thing. That's what... All my friends know Ishawna, and they know that's how I talk. I have a lot of little talk and stuff. So, girl just always call herself girl. Girl, no, no.
Girl,
why.
Okay, because there's a girl in our studio, you know, and she's an artist too.
Yeah.
There's a girl here who's.
No,
and
but
she's
I
girl,
am the girl.
And she's girl, and she is an artist. But I say no more about that. Let's go to your video right now. Right now, right here.
If Instagram fit, tell me who visit my page the most. Your name would have day up at the top. Your mouth a water. The pretty picture when me post you a breeze and me bad. You want have a million girl and if me a 2 man, you a scream on me if you do your that. Remember woman a give man restraining other before them a delete and black. Them have a God complex but me know enough of them a Satan. Me know your heart locked up like Akon. Cause you not get no more invitation. Stop follow me up. You can't keep up but you want a Kardashian.
Wow, high grade. You'll find a high grade. That's some smoke bush weed. Wow. Wait a minute. It's out there already.
Yeah,
spinning,
yeah.
Getting
yes,
rotated.
Getting a lot of great feedback. I mean, there's Alkaline did the male version of his song, Block and Delete. Mm-hmm. So, you know, I just did the female version representing for the ladies as usual. So, you know, them happy for that song right now. So, I just decided to shoot a video for it.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, you roll with Alka more time?
No. But, you know, that's how music is. You know, you get to basically speak for the fans. And everybody knows that my fan base, you know, I have male fans, but but my fan base is the woman them. So I have to speak for them, I have to talk up for them.
This song, this one is
yeah, we're talking about how we have to private the page more time.
It's finding them. This one is finding them.
Yeah, we're not just lurking, right? We're tired. Stop lurking.
Yeah. So this is last quarter. You're setting up, you're positioning this to go into the last quarter.
And then,
to
of
the
course.
With some buzz, right?
So. Yes. And everybody needs someone who's doing very well. I did a video in July, the ending of July, called Everybody Needs Someone, and that's on DJ Frost Rhythm, the all-inclusive rhythm. And trust me, it's like I'm just so shocked how quickly that song is growing, and everybody's loving the video. It's on all the charts and stuff
because
like that.
Because
right
everybody
now.
Needs someone.
Yeah, more time you have to draft your next girl, man. I don't know.
Let's give a little piece of that. Here we go.
Because everybody needs someone. More time you have to draft your next girl, man. Everybody needs someone. Hold you tightly under a slow song. Body wet to a wee, a bus a sweat me a. Breathe hard and me can't catch a breath we a. Embracing so passionate. That love ya exciting like a school set. The time act don't stress it out. Connection strong, rise me up, make me float.
Well, there you have it. Why the woman never go on back?
Over time.
Is it that you? Why? I mean, it sounds like women are in a war with men.
No, we're not. But, I mean, the song Block and Delete, it's basically talk. I don't know if you know the song. He's basically saying, oh, I'm off a block and delete a girl if she go on too hype or too stubborn, right? So I'm just basically representing for us women. Because, yes, men do block women, you know, when they're on their high horse. But then you're blocking us, but you're still lurking on our pages. You still know what we're posting up, and then you want to beg us back. So sometimes us as women, we have to private the page for real, so you don't really know what's going on in our lives. Because you want block we, and we can't see where I go on your page, but you want come lurk so all our page. You know, it can't work, so.
Then these are true-to-life issues.
These are real-life issues. So I wouldn't say it's like a war zone or anything like that, but we all, men have stuff that they talk about, and women have stuff that we talk about, so. That's what it's all about at the end of the day, reality, and just telling it like it is, you know?
So you're the voice.
Yeah, just try and speak for them sometimes. Yeah, them want the song, I'm just give them the song.
All right, so where are we going to see you now? Give us a place where to look, come looking at you, for you.
Well, right now, I think next up I'm in Toronto. Mm-hmm. I'll be there in November. And then I go to Florida in December. Of course, you know, Christmas has come up, so it's a lot of shows and stuff like that. Just doing a lot of recordings. I have a lot of new singles coming out, so I want everybody to look out for those stuff as well.
Ishawna, good to have you, as
Thanks
usual.
Thanks for having me, as usual, Winfred. You know, I love you.
Well, you better continue to love me. The other day, it looked like they dropped me.
No, don't say that.
They blocked me.
No, I didn't.
All right, sweetie, it's so good to have you on our stage. And that's our show for this week. Winfred Williams. On behalf of all of us, thanking you for joining us. Do join us again next week for more On Stage.
If Instagram fit tell me who visit my page the most, your name would a day up at the top. Your mouth a water fit the pretty picture when me post you a breeze and me bad. You want have a million girl and if me have two man, you a scream on me if you do your that. Remember woman a give man restraining order before them a delete and block.
Thanks for watching our video. If you are not yet a subscriber, click now and be on stage. Always.